What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to use server profiles on your Apex server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. With so many games and server versions to choose from, it can be difficult to pick which ones to try out. And in most cases, if you want to switch your server's game, it will delete a lot of the important files unless you back them all up first. The good news is, this is no longer a problem with our new server profiles function, since you'll be able to switch from different games in your panel. Now you will be able to try different games without having to risk losing your game files. Let's go over all of the ins and outs of the server profiles. Head to your Apex server panel and stop the server, and in the left-hand menu, select Server Profiles, and on the next page, you should see a migration prompt. Just press Migrate Server, and then the page should reload and provide access to the new profiles page. Now that the server profile page is migrated and ready to be used, let's go over some of the new tools. A new profile can be created at any time by pressing the Create Profile button in the top left of the page. Once that's done, a new prompt will open, allowing you to enter a name, description, and directory. You can also choose whether to auto-activate your profile. After you're done filling out all of the information, press Save. Now that you have access to at least two server profiles, you can switch between them at any time, which means you can switch between different games and not lose any important files. To activate a profile, visit the profile page, find your profile, and then press the Activate button. A prompt will open, asking if you're ready to switch the profile. Press the Activate Profile button to start the switch. After a few moments, you should return to the panel and see your new profile. Sometimes you might want to adjust the details of a server profile, especially the default profile that was created after migrating. To do this, just head to the Edit Your Profile button on the desired server profile. A page similar to the creation page will open, allowing you to enter any name and description that you want to use. Like before, just press Save for these changes to take effect. With each profile being contained in its own folder, it can become a little difficult to track down each profile folder in the FTP file access. This is made easy by using the folder icon near the Edit button. After you press this, you will be asked to log in to your FTP files as usual, but then it will immediately send you to the subfolder for your profile, giving you easy access to the game's files. If you choose to log in through the FTP access on your main panel, just use the Up button to access all of your folders. Your active profile folder will be marked with a small icon, making it easier to find. If you ever want to delete a server profile, just press the X icon under the Actions tab. This will remove all files from this profile, so make sure that they are downloaded ahead of time if you want to keep them. When you're ready, press the Delete button in the prompt to remove the profile and all of the files. Server profiles can completely redefine your server experience, allowing you to keep existing files from existing games or versions to try out others, without having to back them up manually. This can also help to run multiple instances of the same game, but configured differently to allow separate players to join, or to use different plugins or mods in each game. With so many combinations, your customization options are almost limitless. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.